brought me to wanting to explore this topic is the fact that I have firstly discovered a few things about some people that I didn't already know, either because they've shared it in a video or they've shared it with me privately, or they've raised the fact that there's so much that we don't know about each other in this medium, which I think is important not only to acknowledge but to consider in how we interact. But also tied in with that is the notion that somehow this virtual reality in which we engage almost makes it seem as if the solid, physical, practical reality either is of less importance or isn't really quite real. That everything that we are and do is mutable, in the same way that you can manipulate images online, so you can manipulate your reality. And I think these two things are part and parcel of something quite similar, in that we have become so accustomed to operating in this medium, sometimes more so than we are of operating in the flesh, that we fail to take into consideration the sort of things that we would have no choice but to be aware of if we were face to face. When we engage in a place of the visual and of ideas and of personalities, it's very easy to make assumptions that are absolutely way off, and to make judgments based upon this extremely superficial knowledge that we have of each other. I mean, however much candour one uses here, however much of your private life that you share, and it varies enormously from person to person, you still can't have the same kind of understanding of somebody as if you knew them in real life. And yet we're kind of forced to make judgment calls, or to draw conclusions, or to consider what is being said as if we knew far more than we do. I mean, some people don't care at all, do they? They're sort of attacks that some people may find themselves under for absolutely no good reason are often more based upon the lives of the person who is sitting in judgment than it is on their life. Whatever, you know, however superficial that may be, however sort of, you know, from the drive-by shooting of trolling to the relentless hatred that some people feel the need to engage in. And again, that would be much harder. All of that would be much harder in the flesh. You know, if you were meeting somebody at a discussion group, for example, which I suppose, you know, something, what could one compare it with? Because, you know, you can't compare it with meeting somebody in the supermarket and just having a conversation. There's more to it than that, isn't there? Because on the one level, we have quite a consistent long-term view on each other. And on the other hand, we know nothing. Nothing. And I'm not sure how we can do what we do better. How we can actually start to appreciate more the lives, and the difficulties and the vulnerabilities, and you know, the backstory and just the general lives of the people that we're engaging with. Because, you know, what you might choose to present or to talk about or to create may provide some sort of window onto you and your life. Well, everything has to, doesn't it? It's a million miles from exhaustive or complete. And some seem to grasp that quite well. And, you know, people will engage in ideas and in concepts and different perspectives, and just in a respectful, honouring manner of each other, knowing perhaps just how little they know about each other. But that is often not the case. I mean, I'm very fortunate that most of the engagements I have are very respectful, very interesting, very engaging. You know, some people who I've known a lot longer may tease me or try and wind me up or whatever. But I know them well enough and they know me well enough to know that there's no harm intended. But quite often I've seen people inadvertently perhaps pressing somebody else's button and making judgments on them which are in reality quite outrageous considering the lives that they actually do live. And so, you know, this virtual world in which we engage becomes the only world, and people's real lives seem to be of a minor or secondary importance, or of no importance at all to the people who are watching them. There's also the kind of expectation and belief that anybody who makes video should somehow be beyond reproach, be infallible and perfect, and that whatever thoughts they share, it should always be possible to examine them and to find them sound. And if they're not, then condemnation and hatred can ensue. It's odd because there's this expectation of the kind of professionalism that one sees in the mass media, even though, of course, what goes on behind the scenes with those people is every bit as unseen, even if the press is hounding them. You know, they're presenting a front, they're presenting a face, a professional face, not the entirety of who they are. But maybe they just do it in such a way that it's less open to the sort of direct criticism. I don't know, I'm only talking rubbish there. I haven't really thought that bit through at all. But that's a bit sharp, Wally. But I think it's interesting. I think, you know, as we are still in developmental mode with how we engage online, plus the sort of manipulations that take place by those who now control it, we don't have specific answers or ways to do this which are going to work without potential problems. But I do think it's worth raising the issue of our outside lives. I mean, you know, some people you know next to nothing about, and that's fine, that all you're engaged, you're getting to know their ideas, the way they think, the way they present themselves, their personalities, but only on a particular dimension, on a particular layer of their reality and of your reality. Beyond that, you know nothing. And I think that's an important thing to remember and to consider and to judge with. You're better to ask questions, even if you don't get any answers, than it is to assume that somebody is something because of what they present on YouTube. I mean, you know, despite the fact that I have many, many videos going back 10 years, there's still an awful lot that, you know, if anybody watched the entirety of my library. I mean, God, you'd have to be determined and obsessed. But you still, there's still a whole host of stuff you wouldn't know about me. And that's fine. It's just the way it is. But that's true of anyone that we see in this medium. You know, some people are more, perhaps more authentic than others. Some people present their true face. Others don't. Others perform. And that's something else altogether. I'm not even going there right now. But looking at somebody's authentic face doesn't mean that you know who they are or what drives them or what motivates them or the joys or difficulties and anguishes or whatever that they have and the histories that they have in their lives. So what do you think of that? I mean, you're probably aware of it anyway, but I just think it's an interesting thing to explore because we could do with doing what we do better than we do it. I hope everything's going well for all of you.